أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم، حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خير for coming. وبارك الله فيكم. We stopped the last time with Kabira number 35, المحلل والمحلل له. And this is marrying a divorced woman with the intention and in order to make her lawful to her first husband, which after the third time of divorcing, she become forbidden for him. If somebody voluntarily try to make her halal and his intention for marrying is that, that to let her become halal for the first one, then his marriage to her is invalid. And if she goes back to the first one, become also invalid and become both of them, wal'iyazu billah, zina. And we go with all details about it, the last halaqa. And the halaqa of today, kabira number, according to Imam al-Zahabi, kabira number 36, which it is عَدَمُ التَّنَزُّهُ مِنَ الْبَوْلِ. عَدَمُ التَّنَزُّهُ مِنَ الْبَوْلِ means not purifying yourself after urine, not washing your private part after the urine with the water. This is one meaning. Also not protecting yourself from the coming back of the urine. Suppose you are standing, especially for the men. And you know that in the commode, that the, some of the urine will come back, even very little. How you know? If you look at the top of the commode there, you'll find little drop and yellow ones. This is from the urine. If it comes back to your own body, if it comes back to your own body, this is, you are in a big problem because you lost your prayer. This is number one. And itself is, now you are impure. You are not pure. And the order of Allah Azza wa Jal in Surah Al-Muddathir, Surah number 74, Ayah number 4, what Allah said, وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَاهِرْ. Purify and clean your garment. Keep your garment always clean. For that, remember when I said the conditions for the prayer for the purification, your body by wudu and ghusl. And your clothes must be pure. And one of it is to save yourself from the coming back of the small drops. Maybe you will not see by eye, but I'm sure if you are standing especially, that some of it will come back. And number three of that, number one is the body itself by ghusl or by a wudu. Number two, the your clothes. Number three, the place you are bringing. These three must be pure and clean all the time. عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and this hadith is very known in البخاري and Muslim, is very known between the people, that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم passed by two graves. And he said both of them in azab. وَمَا يُعَذَّبَانِ فِي كَبِيرٍ. They are punished, but not because of a big thing. It was in the dunya small. It was easy to avoid it, but they did not. أَمَّا أَحَدُهُمَا فَكَانَ يَمْشِي بِالنَّمِيمَةِ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. One of them, he is in azab in his grave, and this hadith confirming that this azab in a grave. One of them, he used to transfer the word with a bad intention between the people. He heard from here and he gave it to there, and he friend from there and gave it to there, to here, with bad intention to spoil the relation between the people. And the second one, كان لا يستبرئ من البول, أي لا يحترس منه, لا يحترس منه. He does not save and purify. Does not purify, this is one, and everybody knows it. Because after you use the bathroom, you must purify yourself with the water. This one, maybe he purify himself with the water, but the problem is does not save himself and protect his garment, his clothes from the urine if it comes back to himself. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم استنزهوا. Here استنزهوا also contended both meaning. Save yourself and protect yourself and purify yourself from the urine من البول فإن عامة عذاب القبر منه. فإن عامة عذاب القبر منها. Most of the عذاب in القبر because of it. Most of the people who's punished in the grave, the reason of their punishment in the grave because they did not purify, they didn't protect themselves. Because, think about it, this is narrated by Imam al-Darqutni. Think about it. If you do not know about it all of your life, then you will die while you are impure and your salah is gone and have no wudu. If you never think about it and does not come to your mind, even it is already mentioned now in the books and you did not know it, for that a lot of people are having this mistake whilst you don't know. For that, this is the duty of a Muslim to learn his own religion. Then he said, ثم إلا من لم يتحرز من البول في بدنه وثيابه فصلاته غير مقبولة. Whoever does not save and protect himself and protect his body and his clothes from the coming back or returning of some of the urine, then his salah is unacceptable. His salah is invalid. وفي ابن أبي الدنيا والطبراني روى الحافظ أبو نعيم في الحلية عن he write it down شقي بن مانع but I think it is شفي بن ماتع عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أربعة يؤذون أهل النار على ما بهم من الأذى. Four different kind of people, they will be giving more torture to the people of Jahannam more than what they have. Four people, they will have punishment and their punishment will insult and will annoy people of Jahannam more than what they already have because of their azab. يسعون ما بين الحميم والجحيم, and they are between the boiling water and between the hellfire. ويدعون بالويل والثبور, and they are screaming and yelling and they are in a very big punishment. ويقول أهل النار لبعضهم بعض ما بال هؤلاء قد آذونا على ما بنا من الأذى. What happened to those people already who have enough? What happened to those people? They having more punishment and this punishment bothering us more than what we already have punished. Who are they? Number one, رجل معلق أو مغلق عليه تابوت من جمر. A man, to explain it, the jamr, when you bring the iron become very red. Bring iron and heat it so high until it becomes so red, this is named jamr. For that, a man who's in a cage made out of this jamr. ورجل يجر أمعاءه, and a man his stomach is losing and he is pulling it, walking and it is behind him. ورجل يسيل فمه قيحا ودما, and another man coming from his mouth a lot of blood and a lot of pus. ورجل يأكل لحمه, and another man, these four different kind of people bothering even people of Jahannam. And a man is eating his own flesh. فيقال لصاحب التابوت, will be said to the man in the jamr cage, ما بال الأبعد قد آذانا على ما بنا من الأذى. What happened to you? Why you are in this punishment and you are punishing us by seeing you or by having that more than what we already have. فيقول إن الأبعد مات وفي عنقه أموال الناس. He will answer them, the reason of the punishment I have is I die and I did not pay the money I borrowed from the people. This is one meaning. Other meaning exactly that die while he have money of people. It could not be only borrowing, maybe it was amana with him, maybe he steal it, maybe Allah knows. But it is, he's saying, في عنقه أموال الناس. He have some money for people and he die does not return it. Either amana or borrow or whatever it is. Or that he is in this kind of azab because of what he did in the dunya. ثم يقال للذي يجر أمعاءه. It will be said to the one who pulling his own stomach is losing everywhere. out of his belief. And they will say to him, "You are, we already يعني, getting insulted and getting annoyed of what you have already. What the reason?" فقال كان لا يبالي أينما أصاب البول منه ولا يغسله. He does not take care of the urine. Doesn't matter where it is, it goes. It goes even including his own body, and he does not wash it. With another way, does not purify, does not save himself from the urine. With a third way, he is not pure, he is impure. ثم يقال الذي يسيل فمه قائحا ودما. Then it will be said to the one whose mouth bringing blood and bass. What's the reason why you are in this عذاب? قال كان ينظر كل كلمة قبيحة فيستلذها. He used to say to every bad word and he used to enjoy it. Enjoy by saying, enjoy by insulting, enjoy by even thinking about it, because Muslim should control his tongue. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم already said in the other hadith, من يضمن لي ما بين فكيه وما بين فخذيه أضمن له الجنة. Whoever guarantee me whatever between his jaw, which is a tongue, whatever between his private lab, which it is a private part, I guarantee him al-Jannah. Whoever guarantees that from doing any wrong or committing any haram, whoever guarantees a private part from committing zina, then guaranteed al-Jannah. Here, because he used to enjoy every bad word to everyone. Then have another narration, but then the number four, the one who eating his own flesh, كان يأكل لحوم الناس ويمشي بالنميمة بين الناس. He used to eat the flesh of the other people by backbiting them. Because backbiting the other in Islam consider as if you eating the flesh of the others. And he used to transfer the word between the people with a bad intention to spoil the relation between them. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى العفو والعافية بمنه وكرمه. Ask Allah by His great name to save us from that. الإمام الذهبي, he make it about this purifying and protecting yourself from the urine very short. And inshallah, ask Allah by His great name to make me able, inshallah the next time will be Kabira number 37, which it is about show off. And show off, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the most thing I fear about my ummah is the show off. أخوف ما أخاف على أمتي الشرك الأصغر. The most thing I fear about my ummah is show is a shirk al-asghar, the minor shirk. They said, يا رسول الله, what it is? قال الرياء. He said, the show off. When you do the thing not for Allah. Because look to your intention when you do any good deeds. If it is completely sincerely for Allah, this is what Allah wants. But what about if it is for the people? This is show off. For your own self is not for Allah. For the dunya. Because Rasulullah confirmed it. فمن كانت هجرته لدنيا. Whoever migrate for a dunya. My intention not coming here for da'wah, for my certificate. This is not for Allah. For that, correct your intention and do everything you're doing to sincerely only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, you're losing what you are doing. For that, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, show off. قال يقول الله عز وجل يوم يجازي الناس العباد بأعمالهم. When Allah will, subhanahu wa ta'ala, will give the reward and will give the account to the people about their own deeds. اذهبوا إلى الذين كنتم تراؤونهم بأعمالكم فانظروا هل تجدون عندهم جزاء. Go to those people you used to, Allah will say to the people who used to do good deeds but not for Allah, for the sake of the people. Allah will say to them, go to these people and see if you are able to get any good reward or any good thing from them for whatever you do for them. With another way, go to those people you used to show them off and let them reward you for what you did for them, because you didn't do it for Allah. You want the reward from Allah? Do it sincerely for Allah. But do not do it for Allah and for the people, for Allah and for the dunya, for Allah also two intention. Already the hadith, I don't know if you bring it or not, a man asked Rasulullah, I'm going for jihad. For Allah and also, he said to Rasulullah, and for also the people to praise me, that I'm a brave man and I'm a good one. What's my reward? قال لا شيء لك. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم answer him directly, nothing you will get. You will get no any reward at all. Then he explained it. إن الله يحب من العمل ما كان خالصا له. Allah love from you to do the deed completely and perfectly, sincerely to him alone. Sincerely to Allah. For that, look to your intention before you do any good deeds. And during doing it and after it. Is it for Allah or no? If it is for Allah, go on. If it is not, correct your intention. For the dunya, I am making friendship with this brother in order to marry his sister. This is not for Allah at all. I am trying to be good with this man, not for the sake of Allah, because I need so and so and so and so and this and that. Then not for Allah. Coming for the prayer in order the people trust me is not for Allah. Because sometimes intention is very flexible. If you do not control it, then it will take you everywhere. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اللهم كفر عنا سيئاتنا اللهم توفنا مع الأبرار اللهم ارحنا وافرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين يا رب العالمين اللهم رب الناس مذهب الباس اشف أنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاؤك شفاء لا يغادر سقما اللهم رب الناس مذهب الباس اشف أنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاؤك شفاء لا يغادر سقما اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى وارحنا وافرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا ويسر لنا امورنا واشرح لنا صدورنا واغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا واعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا رب اللهم اعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك يا ذا الجلال والاكرام اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين فوق كل ارض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.